have shedlings. Here's how to defeat them. Verminator presents How to Defeat Shedlings. Follow our simple grooming tips to get rid of them. To remove loose hair from shedding up to 99%, use 10 to 20 minutes per week. The new stainless steel curved edge follows your pet's natural shape. With Skin Guard feature, the tool gently glides over your pet's skin without digging in at the edges. To de-shed your pet, choose the right de-shedding tool to match your dog's body size and hair length. With short, gentle strokes, use the tool to reach deep under the pet's top coat to remove the loose undercoat. This is where all the stubborn shedding comes from. The Verminator de-shedding tool works on cats as well. Grooming, bathing, discarding, and de-shedding means less sheddings. That way with Frontline Plus. It kills fleas and ticks on your pet. Plus, its added protection stops flea eggs that fall off your pet from hatching in your home. Don't just kill fleas, tackle their eggs too. Use Frontline Plus.
You know your pet's individual character. But IAMS knows the nutrition they need for 7 signs of healthy vitality, all with a great new taste and a brand new pack, full of character, full of IAMS.
We've been feeding Charlie the new and improved Eukanuba now for 12 weeks. He's totally thriving. During the time that he's been eating the new Eukanuba, he's lost 4.5 centimetres of his weight. This makes me feel absolutely so proud and really happy with the fact that we've taken the best care of Charlie.
Me and Charlie had a race in the park and he beat me. He's never done it
before. Good morning, everybody, and welcome to day 3 of Across 2019. We have a fantastic day again for you here in the main arena. We've got agility, we've got the police, we've got lots of rescue dogs as well. So we've got another fantastic day lined up for you. Remember as well, we've got the whole of Crufts in the other 5 halls, over 400 trade stands. Make sure you take your credit cards and buy yourselves an early Christmas present. So our first agility competition of the day is the international. We're all about the international competitors today here in the main arena. So we do need a judge for our first competition, which is the international jumping. Please put your hands together for Hilary Bowden. Oh, Hillary's brought her fan club with her. So all our competitors today are, like I said, international competitors. And for some of them, it'll be their first time running at Crufts. First on the line, not too far away from the Isle of Man. We have Stephen Goldsmith with Teddy, the Border Collie. Flickaway is my kind of bear. First time at Crufts for this pair. So this is jumping round. Later on, we'll be going to the agility. And the 2 rounds together will give us a final tonight, which will be very, very exciting. I can assure you, you'll love that. We're on 5-4, we just took a pole down. And unfortunately, that is the wrong way around the course. He needed to go into the weave poles. So that's an elimination for Steve and Teddy. So we're coming over the finishing line. It's a lovely finish. Well done, Steve. So next to go on the line, Sergio de Souza from Portugal. This is a border collie called Cat, majestic in the star. Had a very impressive international career. Lots of international agility champion titles. That's a fast line down to the Ike's jump there. Just took that pole, so we're on 5-4s. Now remember, it's an accumulation of the two rounds, so our handlers will know that they need to keep going and go as fast as they can, because you just never know what everyone else will do. Changing sides there, we're into the final straight. So we're on 5-4s and 30.347 currently goes into the lead. So next on the line is Tanya Visma with Twilight from the Netherlands. 5-year-old border collie, Bark at the Moon Magic Twilight. Second year here at Crufts. Straight down that very fast line. Tanya turning right. Into the weaves. Got to go into those weave poles with the first pole on the dog's left shoulder. Through the tunnel. Oh, well recovered. Saw that other tunnel. It's a big draw. Unfortunately, though, that's 5 on the long jump. Keep going. One more to go. 5-4s, 35.109 goes into second place. Didn't quite make it over the long jump there. So, next to go. This is Jenny Dam with Lily from Sweden. Away to meet Miss Lily. I think this is the last year's winner, actually, if I'm not mistaken.
Lily, sing.
Left on the arms jump there, across the weaves. Nicely done. Nicely through there. Right over the wall, through the tunnel. Getting a turn in to tell the dog it's turning left. And here we go, into the final straight. It's a quick one, one to go. 32.003 on a clear round. Well done. That goes into first place. Okay, so this is Dawn Greer. Just picked up 5-4s there on the first jump. First Light Navigator is the dog's name, Teddy. This is from the Republic of Ireland, so again, not too far away. One of our own, as it were. Picks up 5 for a missed weave entry. So we're on 10. As we come out of those weaves down through the Irons jump. Very grateful to Ireland and Ukanuba for their support of Crufts. That's another refusal there, so that's 5. And that's another refusal. So if the dog has 3 refusals anywhere on the course, that does mean an elimination, I'm afraid. So Teddy has been eliminated, isn't he? No, he's still happy. Okay, so next to go, this is Mette Berger from Denmark with Lady, the border collie. Lady. Peter's been in the Danish Championships for the last 5 years. Motoring down towards that Irons jump.
6-6-6-6-6-6-6.
Getting away from the weeds, letting the dog carry on. Here we go, over the wall. Left turn, nicely done there. Over the long jump, here's that right turn on the Irons jump, and we're into the final straight. Come on, lady, one to go. Well done. It's a clear round. 34-7-4-2 goes into second place. Well done. That's a good place to be going into the agility later on. So next to go, Nick Loizos from Wales. Skilo, the working sheepdog, Skilo Silver Swirling. This is a rescue dog. Saw the weaves, unfortunately. So picks up an elimination there.
Weave.
So after our international jumping event, ladies and gentlemen, we've got the small teams. That's always a good competition to watch. So here we go, into the final straight.
Go, 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 go.
So. Just getting a bit distracted there. Well done. I think he was expecting his toy or something. Unfortunately, he didn't get it for not doing the last jump. He's got it now, though, I'm sure. Okay, so next to go. This is Naomi Kamida with Swanee Diesel from Japan. 4 years old, Border Collie. I think you might say that as Suni. But anyway. I apologise for all my pronunciation in this competition. Very nicely. Wow, look at that. But unfortunately, it was so quick it picked up a fall. So we're on five. Twisting and turning as we come down through the tunnel. Manages to make the turn. Swapping sides, it's a quick one as we come down the final straight. One more, well done. 5-4, 35, 3-8-1 goes into fifth place. So next to go on the line, Valerie Malbranca from Belgium. Linka, the Border Collie. Oh, the pole's gone down, so we're on five. Very, very successful international career. Turning right into the tunnel. Oh, they're seeing that tunnel as they come out. There's two straight tunnels. It's a big draw. Here we go into the final straight. We're on five. One to go over the spread. 34-194. Five corks. Goes into fourth place. Now, I know we're all biased, but I think we need to support Natasha Wise from England. This is Pebbles, the Border Collie. Agility champion Nedlo, flipping shiny Pebble. Had a good day yesterday. Wow, look at that. Straight across, down to the Irons jump. Good weak, left turn weak, there. Weak. Into the weeds, nicely done. Trying to keep these turns down. Tunnel, here's the left turn. That's a good one. Here we go. Down to the Irons jump, right turn. And into the final straight. Let's cheer them on. Come on, Tash, yay! 30.385 goes into first on the clear round. That's a great start to the day for England. Well done, Tash. Okay, so next on the line, Cynthia Perrier from France. This is Heros. another very successful international career. Going down to the iron stream. Nicely done into the weeds. Left turn. Ooh. hanging on. Here we go. Into the tunnel. Left turn. Good dog. Down to the Iams jump. Oh, that wasn't in the plan. Oh, what a shame. That was a cracking run. Unfortunately, picking up an elimination. I think it would have been a good time as well. The dogs are used to sometimes taking the further side of the jump and just misread those cues, unfortunately. So, next to go, this is Lisa Irene Hansen from Norway with Gosh, the Border Collie. So we're seeing a lot of dogs here with very good international careers, competing in the World Championships, etc. And this dog has also a very long list on the card. Crawling into that tunnel. Good turn. So we come down the line. Right turn. Here we go into the final straight. Come on, Norway. Well done. 32.499 goes into third place on a clear round. Well done. So next to go, another one close to home. This is Laura Short from Scotland. This is Bruce, agility champion. Give it some juice, Iron Bruce. Again, another dog that's been on the international scene. Gets into those weave blocks. Look at that, very nice and done. He's gonna squeak all his way around. He enjoys his agility, what do you reckon? In agility, oh, missed the long jump, what a shame. What a shame, I think Laura was just getting into position there to get a tight turn on the Iams jump, but unfortunately just took off his line. So unfortunately eliminated there for Laura and Bruce. We will see them later on though in the agility. So this is Anita Le Morsoria. Hope I've got that right, from the Channel Islands, probably not. But this is Basil, the Australian Kelpie. Devonair's Basil Brush. Down that very long straight, right turn on the iron stuff. Past the wall. Unfortunately, he's gone past the weaves as well, just didn't see them. So five falls for a refusal. Turning him away from the tunnels, but he just clocked the weaves there, but well recovered. So left there, so that's a five, and that's another five there. So we are on 15. And we're into the final straight. Well done, Basil. Just took out that last pole on the spread. So next to go, Peter Crozier from Northern Ireland. Woo! There they are, behind us. This is Jack, the Collie Cross Flatcoat Retriever. Melbrake Jack of Hearts. First time at Crufts for the dog, second time for Peter. And Jack was a rescue dog. So, agility is a great sport, it's very inclusive. It doesn't matter if you have a pedigree dog, a crossbreed, a rescue dog, doesn't matter what size it is. You can register on the activities register and get involved with your local club. Come on, Peter. Come on, let's go into the final straight. Come on, one more. Yeah, well done. 34.034. on a clear round, goes into fourth place. Well done. Look at the concentration. What a great run. Well done, Peter. Okay, so next to go, Silva Nuno from Luxembourg with Ginger, the Border Collie. Also brought his fan club today, which is great. This is Lordy Miss Claudie. Spelt as in claws, which is quite clever. Claws on a dog, that is. Into the poles. That's a good turn, probably the best turn maybe we've seen there today. Into the tunnel, keeping down the stride there. Here we go, into the final straight. Come on, Ginger, we're into the final run. It's a cracking run, well done. Well done, 31, 229, goes into second place. Well done, Silva. Another great run, look at that turn. Agility is all about accuracy and speed. So our handlers are trying to keep the turns down to a minimum, as much as possible. Okay, next to go. This is Simon Brenker with Cute from Switzerland. Another Border Collie. Registered name, Amy von Linter. This is the second to last dog to go. Picks up five. Pole's gone down, unfortunately. Here we go. Down the straight. We're on five. Well done. Ooh, look at the time. Great time. 30.322 with five penalty faults. That was a cracking time. I think it probably would have taken the top spot, but unfortunately with five. So, next to go, this is Christina Garcia with Inca. Unfortunately, that's an elimination. So this is Cinca de Scofos. I don't know if I've said that right, hopefully I have, from Spain. Unfortunately, the dog picked up the weave poles and has been eliminated. But remember, we've got the agility later on. And all still to play for. Our handlers will be fighting for a place in the final tonight. So that's it. That's it, Hillary. That was our last dog. So I think you'll agree, a great competition. Like I say, the agility's later on. We're going straight on to the Crufts small team. So don't go away. That will be after the presentation. Ladies and gentlemen, it's presentation time. Okay, so this is the International Jumping Large. In first place, it's Natasha Wise, agility champion Nedlo, flipping shiny pebble from England. And our runner-up from Luxembourg, Silva Nuno with Lordy and Miss Claudie.
Millie would be very quiet. She would have her head down and be really withdrawn. She's got Down syndrome, she's got pulmonary hypertension, low muscle tone, and anxiety. Since having Emma, she's totally changed. As long as she's got Emma in the vicinity, she's great. It's really given her so much more confidence. The worries that we had before we got Emma was that Millie would be kind of left on her own. She wouldn't have a companion. Millie was really scared of dogs. When we went to Dogs for Good, Millie was playing on the climbing frame. We were dropping treats down the slide to Emma on the way home. She said, "I like that doggy, Daddy. She's nice and fluffy," which then started their bond and their journey together. Which one's your favourite dog?
Emma. She's my favourite.
She is your favourite. Emma and Millie are very coordinated already. They're just growing all the time together. She's really in tune with Millie. Their personalities are quite similar. They like their quiet time and that they love to play. They really interact really well. Millie comes home from school. First person she goes to is Emma, straight past Dad, past everyone. Emma gives her hugs. What do you do when you come home and see Emma? What do you do with her?
I cuddle her.
Do you give her big cuddles or little cuddles?
Big cuddles, like this.
Emma can open doors for Millie. Millie has medication in her drinks. Millie will leave them in places. We don't know where they are. We ask Emma. Emma will go and find it and bring it back to us. What sort of tricks does she do?
She gets my cup.
She gets your cup. Emma will go up and do a headrest on it when she's out of breath. She just supports her in so many different ways.
Yeah.
As Millie grows, having Emma beside her, it's given me and Chris a sense of comfort to know that she's always got a best friend in Emma. And just seeing them grow together is something that we're really looking forward to. She just pulls the whole family together somehow. She we all go out for walks, even when it's pouring with rain, we'll all be out having a walk together. I think she just helps the whole family just become more of a unit with the bond that Millie and Emma have got together and just the way it's been growing. It's been fantastic.
Do you love your doggy?
Yeah.
Rosenthal here alongside Graham Partridge. We've got a fantastic day ahead of us of international agility competition right at the front of house. The arena announcer is walking round the arena, walking round the circuit. Graham, good morning to you. Just give us your initial thoughts about what is facing the team relay agility, the small final, which will be getting underway in just a few moments' time.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome. I hope you can have a fantastic day with us. We're just about to start the small team agility. And as you can see now, our announcer, Nigel, is walking around explaining where the course goes. It's a very nice course. Quite a few twists and turns, and this is where it can get difficult for the handlers. As I say, this is a pressure situation. Not only have they got the pressure of running their own dog round, they've got the weight of the other team members hanging around their neck as well. So he's just indicating the seesaw there. The dog must be on the seesaw when it touches the ground in order to avoid a fault. And he's just coming now towards the end of the course. And he's just explaining that they're coming, approaching the jump that he's looking at very, very quickly. And then they've got to get a really, really sharp turn off that one to try and save as much as they can. Another 180 degree turn there and a nice fast finish. So overall, really nice course.
We have got a fantastic, very, very big YouTube club watching Crufts in massive numbers. We have broken our record again. First day, 240,000. Second day, 266,000 live hits on YouTube. We're going for the million mark by the end of the show tomorrow. We appreciate your company. And don't forget, you can always get in touch with us as well to get any questions answered that you want. Hashtag Ask Crufts. And Graham, we've got a couple for you now before the action gets underway. This from Daniel DeWitt. How do I get my dog to go through the tunnel without the going in and stopping them deciding it's playtime when it's in there?
Very, very easy. The tunnels that you see on screen now actually squeeze up so that you can get them to within a metre or so long. You hold your dog at one end, you get your friend to go at the other end and perhaps hold a toy or a titbit. and then you actually release the dog into the tunnel and it will go through and hopefully find the toy or the titbit, and then you gradually do that by increasing the length of the tunnel. Dogs naturally like tunnels as well, but they just need an incentive to go right the way through it and get to the other end, and that incentive is either a toy or some titbits.
This one from Emily D. Can a seven-year-old dog learn agility as we welcome our judge, Hilary Bowden, here?
Yes, most definitely you can, and please, if you've got a seven-year-old, go out and do it.
And very quickly, the last one, Ben from Ipswich. Which obstacle should you teach first?
I would teach the jump first, and I'll touch on that just a bit later on, because I think we're just about to start.
Well done. Keep those questions coming in. So it's essentially a relay, four dogs, four handlers. The baton gets passed around. This for the small dogs. A faulty changeover, 20 faults. They must complete the course. If not, the whole team is eliminated. We have nine teams going here. And first to go, Cornforth United, Northern Team Small from Barnard Castle in County Durham. Jackie Tarn and Lee, four-year-old Cocker Spaniel. We are up and running. Third day competition at Crofts. And there's a little twist and a turn from Lee that won't help her time at all in and out of the tunnel that Graham has just been talking about. Noisy little dog, bit of hesitation, but in at the right side of the weaves. That is good. Little hop over the wall and clear at the moment. Clear and tidy and reasonably quick as well. A good opening for Cornforth United Northern teams. And Jackie Tarn. Again, just a slight bit of hesitation on that far side of the course, and now the baton will be handed over to Sue Everett and Blip, 10-year-old Cross. Rescue dog always puts in 100%. These the small dogs, remember. We're going to see some quick, lively, small dogs for the next half an hour or so here in the main arena at the NEC.
Yep, into the weaving poles there and out, over the wall, and into the tunnel now, the dog walk. They must make contact with the white areas on each end of this dog walk, and that's to make sure that we get some control and the dogs don't run around out of control. So now we go into the tunnel. Now we've got a few tight turns coming up here. This is the first one, so 180 degrees around that one, and then 180 degrees around this one, and then straight out for the finish and handing over to dog three.
And dog three is a River, 8-year-old poodle, and Kelly Harrison, River, absolute sweetheart. Always a lovely sight here at Crofts, seeing poodles in the agility, and a bit of hesitation, and the old clenched fist goes up from Hilary, and that'll be five faults at the moment.
Yes, five faults for refusal, and three refusals anywhere on the course will eliminate the dog. And if a dog does get eliminated anywhere on this course, it must complete it correctly, because if it doesn't complete it correctly, the whole team will be eliminated. But only five faults, and picking this up really, really well. A nice quick finish here. The last dog of the team about to go.
Last dog is Paul Sims and George Scotty Cross Cocker, 3 years of age, a rescue dog, loves agility, and an absolute dream for these two to be running at Crofts, and this dream has come true, as says Paul, thanks to his team, which is Cornforth United Northern Teams. And of course, this is the small dog section. So this has been a very tidy opening effort for the first of nine teams, Cornforth United from Barnard Castle in North England. And they've kept the faults down and they've kept the speed up as well. So they've set a very distant, very decent benchmark. One down.
And what a great effort that is. Only five faults, time of 184.792.
So our next team in are called the Melton Agility Poodle Division.
There we go, just a little bit of hesitation, double footing through those weaves.
Anyone for Melton Mowbray? Anyone like Melton Mowbray pork pies? That'll do. Right, so as we can see, team of poodles. First one to go will be Gemma.
Thumbs up, celebration. Second team to up and running Melton Agility Poodle Division from Melton Mowbray. And we're looking at Gemma Conroy and Lola, 5-year-old toy poodle, starting in very lively fashion. In fact, they started doing this just for a little bit of fun, never expected to have any competition, but reached grade 7 last year, top grade, and qualified for this. Can't quite believe it that they are here, they are competing, and they made a very decent start to their round. Second time at Crufts. Took by the McGree show in 2015. And a little bit of hesitation, more hesitation. Hop just about made the contact. Benefit of the doubt given there to Lola and to Gemma.
Okay, so she's coming back now towards the box. They've changed over a baton here. Must be changed hand to hand. The baton will remain in the box. And this is Jan Carroll with her Casper the toy poodle, 9 years of age. There is no maximum age that they compete. The only rules that we have is that the dog must be 18 months of age to start competing at Kennel Club. Into those weaving poles, must enter to the right, and it must do them in and out after that. It made a mistake, so you'll see the judge raise her hand with an open hand, which signals 5 faults. You can only get 1 set of 5 faults within the weaving poles. So now up and over the A-frame. Beg your pardon, the dog walk. Not even similar, are they? Onto the seesaw. Seesaw must touch the ground now into the tunnel. I'll get this right one day. I've only been doing it 35 years. I'll learn to tell the difference soon.
You used to smack me on the wrist for calling dog walks A-frames and things like that.
I did.
Ah, well, that's made my crops, that is. Here goes Sue Hargreaves with the 5-year-old mini poodle. Forgive me if I have a little chuckle for the next minute or so. First time at Crufts then. I'll sort him out, Graham, don't worry. They can give him a little tutorial after this. He'll be absolutely fine later in the day. Very nervous little dog, this one. But just the 5 faults so far, and Melton Agility Poodle Division. Second team to run here this Saturday morning at Crufts. And sadly, that is an elimination, but the course will have to be completed, and that means the penalty points will rack up. 105 now. Last one to go, Daryl Goddard, with Berry, the 3-year-old toy poodle. Grade 7, 4th agility dog, this one, been competing for 10 years, but first time at Crufts, and you cannot overestimate, really, what this means. It's good speed from Daryl and Berry.
Here we go. Round 218. Coming down the line with 2.
And there's a finish.
Well done.
We are hearing from down there, actually, that the whole team might just have been eliminated for failing to complete the course. One of the dogs, the third dog, I believe. Quickly, Graham.
There we are, just watching the dog go over the seesaw and now into the weaves. Nicely done. So over the jump. And unfortunately, she took the wrong jump there.
Hamish Parsons, Jack Russell Terry, 6 years of age, first time at Crufts.
Stacey's Manic Minis from London, next to go in this small team competition. Angus McFarlane with Hamish, 6-year-old Parson, Russell Terrier. First time at Crufts for Hamish. And away we go. 5 faults, just didn't make the contact point coming down the A-frame. Angus and dog in perfect sync going into the weaves. Cleverly over the wall, and in and out of the tunnel right in front of us. I think they call that the dog walk. Over the seesaw as well. Through the tunnel. And oh dear, there is a crossed arm that means an elimination. Still complete the round, and of course still two more dogs to go. Lucas Irwin Burns, 8-year-old Jack Russell Cross. Sam competed at the Junior European Open Championships last year and won an overall prom, so they have a bit of quality in their team. Stacey's Manic Minis, these two from Peacehaven. And this is just going off the side of the seesaw. But this is a good, really good effort by the third dog, by Lucas and by Sam. Handing over now to the third dog, to Amy Bennett and Hush, 7-year-old Shetland sheepdog. First time in the main ring. And a sensitive little soul, Graham. Perhaps not quite the arena for sensitive little souls, this.
No, I didn't, but Amy will, is a very experienced handler. She will just take her time, help the dog as much as she possibly can. Take nothing for granted when you're in these situations. You want to just keep that dog's confidence. She'll be talking to it all the time. Notice how she's looking at the dog as she's running along, just to make sure. And if you can keep that eye contact, it just helps the dog along just that little bit. Ideally, you don't want to be looking at the dog all the time, but she's doing that just to keep the dog focused and keep it with it. And she's doing an absolutely fantastic job here as we come back in for this changeover. And you'll see the baton being held out. Amy takes it and hands over to the next dog.
Stacey Irwin Burns and Boo, 10-year-old Jack Russell Cross at Cavalier, retiring from agility after today. An incredible one to run and to train. And Boo has taught Stacey a huge amount along the way. Through the weaves.
Yep, another very experienced partnership here. As you say, it's always a little bit emotional when you think this is the last appearance, but this dog's done Stacey very, very well, and I'm sure he'll still be doing a little bit of agility, just a bit more for fun, and he'll be spending getting even more cuddles than he gets now. So this is the last dog to go, and it looks so. Unfortunately, they've had an elimination there, which scores 100 faults. That's why they ended up on 110 penalties. But a really good time, 174.523. Which puts them into second place. The up and over Tigers small team. Lovely little dog, that nicely made contact. Look at those ears flapping everywhere.
Katie Beecham and 6-year-old Bella Cockapoo, the next team, Up and Over Tigers from Coventry. Grade 7 agility dog, and absolutely loves it, and looking to give Up and Overs a flying start here. Always have a bit of fun, and we always believe, Graham, that those three letters and that word mean everything here at Crofts. Everyone should have fun when they come to Crofts.
They should, and they do. This is just a big game to these dogs. They all love it, and if anything goes wrong, it's always the handler's fault. And you may laugh when they say that, but it is. You've either given the dog the wrong signal at the wrong time, told it wrong, or you haven't trained it well enough. But Up and Over Tigers always put out a very experienced team here, so I expect them to be well in the mix at the end.
Next to go for Up and Over Tigers is Selena Bray, a familiar surname in the canine world, Alan's daughter. Raid, 4-year-old working Cocker Spaniel, a fantastic family pet, this one. And what better way than keep your family pet active and fit and happy than to do agility. Look at that over the platform. That really, really was quick. Just a bit of hesitation at the end of the seesaw, but this is just about the quickest we've seen this morning. Good tight turn as well. Well done, Selena, and well done, Ray. They really have picked up a lot of time in that round. That is excellent. Here comes Alan, keeping it in the family. Tikita, we've seen this one. We've seen her over the last couple of days, an absolute live wire. And looking at this, Up and Over Tigers could well be taking control of this competition if things keep going like they are at the moment. Well done, Alan. Just a slight bit of hesitation, but corrected it. Dog walk right in front of us is good. This is a terrific round. Just a bit of a pause at the end of it. Seesaw, excellent contact at the end. Whoa, look at that. And flying through the tunnel at the end. Tikita, what a lovely, lovely little dog this is. And that's a terrific round from Alan and from Tikita. Not the quickest changeover, but here goes Lauren Langman. And this blink if you've been watching on YouTube over the last couple of days. This one is an absolute flyer. Won the individual agility yesterday, came second overall, but Blink an absolute favourite across 29. Look at the speed of Blink, the working Cocker Spaniel. Fantastic. Looks to me like up and over Tigers. If they keep this going with Lauren and Blink, they are going to take a huge amount of beating. 161 and clean.
Absolutely amazing. And if you want to know what the definition of pressure is, you running in a team, the last dog to go, and the first three have gone really clear. The fourth person has got the weight of the world on them. Great A-frame. Now, onto the seats. Brakes on. Oh, yes, just about. What a great stop that was. And there we go, the famous blink. Blink and you miss it.
Stamford Small Banana Splits are next to go. 15, Wendy Gilpin and Raven. Good support for them as well. Raven currently competing at grade 5. 7-year-old Cavalier King Charles Spaniel. And at that time, 161.9 and clean. Will take some beating. In your own time, I can think I can safely say that the way they have started this, that Stamford Small Bananas will not be quicker than the up and overs.
Three more dogs to go, though. You don't know what's coming. What you want is to put a clear round on the board to start with. She's going round here very nicely. A lot of pressure on these dogs out here. They're unused to the green carpet, the pressure. It really is. Everything is happening out there, and they never do anything like this throughout the year, and probably only one or two times in their career.
Next to go is Sarah Bunsen Buster, 8-year-old Chinese crested. First time at Crofts, first obstacle successfully negotiated. Buster actually, nice story, was seriously ill back in August 2017. So unbelievably, Buster and Sarah are here and are able to compete. So a lot of sympathy and a lot of admiration as well for this particular pairing. And Buster now, though, he's quite enjoying his club stake. Where do you want me to go next? The dog walk. That's okay. Good contact made at the end of it as well. Seesaw crashes down. That's a good effort from Buster and from Sarah. Unforgiving clock ticking away. It's an excellent round that. Handing over to Amanda Spinks and Jack, 12-year-old toy poodle. 12-year-old toy poodle. And picking up two penalties on that one.
Yep, just unfortunate. Missed the contact on the A-frame, and it was the A-frame this time. And also missed the, had a pole down. So gaining in confidence now as you go around. You can quite often see dogs that haven't been here before, a bit unused to it. As you say, they start off just a little bit tentatively and then they pick up speed as they're going around. Bearing in mind that all the teams that we're seeing here this morning have qualified in the face of very stiff opposition. Another five faults there for a penalty on the end of the dog walk. So this is a good chance now just to get up just a little bit more speed as we go. Nice tight turns we're looking for now. Oh. And we come over and hand over to the third dog. The baton gets changed.
This is Julia Durrant and Parker. 7-year-old Jack Russell, third time he's been to Crofts. He just loves the atmosphere here as well. Stamford Small Banana Splits are already something like 40 seconds down on the lightning quick up and overs.
I have to say that up and over's time was absolutely phenomenal. You would struggle to find four quicker dogs in the whole of the country, I would think, at the moment, certainly in the small category. But that's still a really great effort. 21.57 penalties. which will include time faults. And there we are, just a little bit steadier through there, but still having a good time after all. And that would have meant that the dog had a refusal. And there we clearly show the not contacting the white area on the way down.
Third place at the moment.
So the leading time at the moment, no fault, is 161.986. 161.986 is the time to beat. So Ace Poodle Mix.
Ace Poodle Mix from Bristol. Joe Burt, the 16 to go. Max, 7-year-old toy poodle. That awesome time, 161.9 and clear, set by Up and Over Tigers, dominating this competition at the moment. Let's take, see what Max the poodle can do. We know definitely that Max is in the building. Daintily through the reeds. Well done, Joe. Well done, Max. In front of us now, a little left-hander to the dog walk. Perfectly negotiated, sliding off the contact point at the end. Very good. This is a very good start for Joe, for Ace Poodle Mix, and for Max. Just a bit of hesitation there, and sadly picking up 5 penalties. But still a very decent round and a very good time as well, and sadly 5 more picked up right at the end as well. Sally Butler next to go, and Bailey for Ace Poodle's Mix. 5-year-old poodle cross spaniel. Can be a rather lazy dog, this one. Could go faster if he didn't spend so much energy barking around the course. That's what we were told beforehand, and I think they have a point.
It does, but it amazes me how a dog can bark like this, breathe and run all at the same time. But there's also a very valid point here, just people at home be interested. This is a crossbreed, and in Kennel Club rules, you can run pedigree dogs, you can run crossbreed dogs, you can run whatever you want, whereas some places, some competitions, it's only for pedigree dogs. But we love to see all sorts of dogs here at Gruffs. And do you think he's going to stop barking before he gets to the end, Jim?
I don't think so somehow. Well done with that one, Graham. Sally Hunt next to go on Harley, 8-year-old toy poodle. And I reckon Ace Poodle Mix will definitely pick up the rosette for the noisiest team we've seen so far. Wow, that is a racket out there.
You wait till we get to any Border Terriers, I tell you. But now I shall get in trouble with all the Border Terrier handlers out there, so I do apologise. So nicely made contact now onto the seesaw. This is where we have asked for a bit of control. It must touch the ground before they get off it. And now a nice quick bit now before we ask them to turn 180 degrees. And another one of those now. Shows good control into the box for hopefully a good change over here.
Last to go, Martin Watson Pip. Their Ace Poodle Mix, so 7-year-old toy poodle, this one, small in stature but with a massive personality. And these two have a very close relationship indeed, claiming to be connected by something like an invisible string, according to our information. But it's good at the moment. This will be a good finish for Ace Poodle Mix from Bristol as well. But again, couple of points accruing, penalties accruing, probably for not making the contact on the dog walk. Here we are, flying finish to the round then. 186 and 15 faults for Ace Poodle Mix, and they go up into the top three.
It's a very good point just now about connectivity and connected with a piece of string. It is all about communication in this sport. You have to communicate with the dog. You have to have this understanding, which is key to telling the dog where to go and when to go. But a really good effort by that team.
Jennifer is going first, Jennifer Keegan with Tank Papillon. Competed across the last 3 years at the YKC. This is his first time in the main arena. This will be his last competitive run. And delighted that it's across the finish on a
Dare to Dream.
We are 10 years of age, Tank is.
Jennifer Keegan's Dare to Team from Douglas.
Jennifer and Tank.
Pet name is Tank, 10-year-old Papillon. Competed in the Young Kennel Club across the last 3 years. First time in the main arena. It's going to be his last competitive run, this one. Tank, the 10-year-old Papillon, determined to go out on a high.
Nicely handled there. She's on the left-hand side of the weaves,
through the weaves and the left-hander to the wall, and the tight right-hander taking Tank through the tunnel, tidy over the dog walk. Good opening round for Jennifer and for Tank. Where did it go now? Just there, again with a slight bit of hesitation, but it's okay and it's clean. And then there will be the handover at the end of it. Right now, that's good. Good clear round and the time very respectable as well. Jane Wilkinson and Betsy, 7-year-old Border Terrier, third time at Crofts, can be a bit of a loner at home, but put an agility course in front of her and she comes alive.
She does. They all come alive on an agility course, having such a good time out there. I'm not quite so sure about the handlers when you're in a team competition here at Crufts at the biggest and best dog show in the world, but she's having a ball into that tunnel, and now it's a really fast approach onto the dog walk. No time wasted at all now. Round onto the next piece of control equipment. Now again a chance, so to stretch out, it's all about a little bit of control, a little bit of speed, a little bit of control again. That's what we've got here now. This is a nice fast finish into the box for the changeover.
Changeover to Hayley Tindall and Fifi, 8-year-olds at Toy Poodle, and Dare to Dream are going really, really well at the moment. They are right up there in contention. The time is very, very good, and there are no faults on the clock as yet. So this could be good with just the one dog to run after this. And Hayley and Fifi flying through the weaves, scampering in front of us. Great sight over that dog walk. Crowd loving that. Takes the obstacles very well, does Fifi. And there, this team, Dare to Dream, are right in the mix with one to go. And that is Sarah Peel and Megan, 8-year-old Jack Russell, third time at Crofts, last year doing team event. And can they put themselves right up in contention here? I think the time is going to be a little bit slower than up and over Tigers. But this is really good, and Sarah and Megan maintaining the standard. Might not be the fastest dog we've seen, Megan, but it's so important to keep that zero next to the time. Just a couple to go now towards the end of the course, and it's a good time. 185.1 and clean and good enough for second place.
And I think it's probably fair to say that in any other year, apart from this year, that would have been good enough to win. Four clear rounds is no mean feat. To get one dog round here in this environment is a good achievement. To get four round clear is absolutely amazing. So well done to them.
The lady to go will be Tracy Ryan, working Izzy, a Sprocker Spaniel. 4 years of age, Izzy's first time at Crufts. She was rehomed at 7 months, was far too large for her previous owner. She took to agility straight away and loves training with Leslie Olden.
Two to go.
Great place to go.
Nedlow Small from West Parley in Hampshire. Tracy Ryan, Izzy, 4-year-old Cocker Spaniel, first time at Crufts. Was rehomed at 7 months, too lively for her previous owners, but agility sorted Izzy out. She took to it straight away. Just loves it and loves all the training as well. Good start for Tracy and a good start to Izzy. This is the penultimate team, remember. Just one to go after this. And that unbelievable time set by up and over Tigers, 161 is the time they're all aiming for. Just picking up the 5 faults. Izzy and Tracy, Chantal Hutton with Buzz, 4-year-old Shetland sheepdog from Whirlwell near Andover, can be a nervous dog. This one, first time at Crofts Grand.
It is, so with that combination, it is a big ask here, but so as you say, she'll be just concentrating now on giving the dog every encouragement she can, saying, don't be worried, don't worry about this green carpet, these lights, this big crowd, just come on and concentrate on me and have fun like we do every week at the training field. And she's doing a really good job here to keep the dogs focused. And this is where sometimes it can be a little frustrating, because you know that week on, week out, they go just that little bit faster, but now the dog's just a little bit unsure. But you can see it's picking up speed as it gets around this course. She's doing a really, really good job. We've got a nice tight turn now. All just looking at the finish. One more good turn back into that box, and then yes, there we go. Well done. Good, looking for a good changeover.
Chantal Hutton handing over to Jack Ryan and Jet. Rehome Jet loves his agility. Competed for Team GB at the Junior European Opens for the last 3 years. So Jack Ryan, one of the very promising young handlers, and Jet, 6-year-old Pomeranian.
Yes, Jack's been around for quite a long time now, and if you're sat at home with a really, really small dog thinking, my dog can't do agility, look at this. Absolutely has a great time. The only problem is it has to go right to the end of the seesaw to get it to tip, and he did that really, really quickly. The dog's obviously learned that it needs to go right the way up. If you stop early, you're in trouble. But this is a fantastic round here by Jack.
Just five faults for Jack, 145 seconds on the clock. Last to go, April Britton and Halo, 4-year-old Shetland sheepdog, first time at Crufts. Been competing for a couple of years. Import from Belgium is Halo, the Shetland sheepdog. Love seeing the dog go through those weaves, pointing towards the tunnel. April, dog walk, picking up a bit of speed over that, made the contact point as well. That probably the quickest part of the course on that far side once they've negotiated that seesaw. Getting a tight turn. And Nedlow Small. 184 under five faults, up into fourth place at the moment, Graham.
Yes, really good effort, just an unlucky contact fault. And there we are, clearly didn't make contact with the white area, picking up the only fault of the round.
And guess what, they're from Scotland.
Look at that dog having a ball there.
There you go. I like these orange tops. I tend to watch the dogs go round, but unfortunately sometimes yesterday I had this with the orange tops.
They're last so team to go. XL Dog Agility. Mini Mayhem from Livingston, West Lothian. Big support for every competitor north of the border. Pamela Lawson and Ellie, 4-year-old Parson Terrier. Wonderful way to spend her birthday today with Ellie, who's 4 years old and competing at Crufts for the very first time. So happy birthday to Pamela. And just a reminder, the team to beat up and over Tigers, and the time to beat 161 seconds, and they cannot afford any faults as well, and they certainly cannot afford the horrible crossed arms, Graham.
No, they can't. That will incur 100 faults, and they must now go on to complete this course correctly, otherwise the whole team will be eliminated, and that's it's done like that to save a dog shortcutting back to the finish and getting a really, really good time. So that's not a particularly good start, not the start they would have wanted.
Next to go, Tracy Barton and Harry, 8-year-old Jack Russell. First agility dog for Tracy. Named after Harry Potter. So we will look and see what this is of expertise and unrivaled magic. Let me produce there, and that's a little bit of a hesitation, but it's okay. Tracy and Harry. Far end of the course, Harry tail wagging. As we always say here, if they could talk, they'd say we're absolutely loving this, and that's a good round from Tracy and Harry. Very respectable. Derek Elms next to go. With 5-year-old Bunty, rescued at 6 weeks, and has won 2 reserve championship tickets since competing. Picking up a couple of early faults there. Derek and Bunty. So the last team to go in the small agility relay that's got things underway here on International Saturday at Crufts 2019, and we're about to see the last competitor enter the ring when the handover occurs for the XL Dog Agility. Edinburgh, Michelle Henderson and Pinto, eight-year-old toy poodle, first-year Pinto's qualifying for the small championship class at Drums. Talk us through the climax of the competition.
There we are. You see the handler there turning and twisting, making sure that she connects with the dog, always looking over her shoulder when she changes sides in front of the dog. The dog has to know where it's going. These dogs don't know where they're going. The only person who knows is the handler, and the dogs are totally reliant on the handler for all their commands. They can do anything they want, but they can't touch the dog. They indicate to the dog which way they're going by verbal commands. They use their shoulders, they use their arms, their hands. And look at this, all just a little bit of confusion there. Now she's on the wrong side, now confusion reigns. So it's just a bit of time, no faults there, but well done, good finish. Presentation time, and there we see our judge, Hilary Bowden, just stepping into the middle, and she is flanked by Anne Roberts and Maria Johnson. Well, she's not flanked now, but we've got Maria Johnson and Anne Roberts, who are both volunteers. They come here every year to help organise the trophies and rosettes, and they do an absolutely fantastic job, so thank you very much indeed, ladies. So we've got the two teams in the arena, and the presentation to the winner, which was Up and Over Tigers, and they absolutely smashed this competition this year.
Look what I've got for you.
And it
look
was Katie Beauchamp, Selena
look
Bray,
got for you. There
and then
you go.
Her father, so that's Selena getting hers. Lauren Langman will be next. So with Blink. Blink in the Bling collar there, that's Lauren.
Which is a first for me.
And last but not least, the very experienced Mr. Alan Bray. He's won just about everything there is to be won in agility over a number of years with both large, small and medium dogs. And now we come to the runner-up. And that was the team of Dare to Dream. And I have to say that they were very, very unlucky this year to come up a team like the Up and Over Tigers. I think any other year, the round that this team put in would have won. And the team consisted of Jennifer Keegans, Jane Wilkinson, Hayley Tindall, and Sarah Peel. So well done to them. Very well deserved.
International Junior Handling Final. We We have a superb entry this year with an incredible 41 competitors from every corner of the world. Before we start the first round of the competition, it gives me enormous pleasure to ask the organiser of this wonderful competition, Ms. Cartledge, to escort your judge all the way from the USA into the ring. A warm, plus welcome to Jason Hoke. No stranger to crafts, Jason is a truly international figure in the world of dogs. Involved in our sport from an early age, he has been a professional handler and breeder, and is now a respected judge all over the world. He tells me that today's invitation here at Crafts is the honour of a lifetime, which he will cherish forever. Jason is passionate about encouraging the youth of today. He sees them as the backbone and the future of our sport. Jason wishes all 41 of the competitors the very best of luck today. One more time, a warm Crafts international welcome for Jason Hoke. The first of our competitors, all the way from Australia, Destiny Hamilton. Followed by Jana Hoffer from Austria. And Yuri Habakchik from Belarus. Geeta Locks from Belgium. Brazil's Katarina Oiriki. Bulgaria's Elena Stoyeva. Canada and Kayla Penny. All the way from Croatia, Carla Ivancic. And the Czech Republic, Nikola Zlamalova. Representing Denmark, Kamil Erbicek. And Estonia's Hekaterina Boyka. We turn to Finland now. Welcome to Lotta Nikkanen. Et la belle France, Elaine Tongy. And representing Germany, Johanna Seeger. And Gibraltar's Emily Feek. Coming from Greece, we have Katerina Yano. Followed on by Hungary, Nicolette Rosman. Iceland, Vaka Vithistotir. And the Emerald Isle, Ireland's Sarah Cushley. A warm cross welcome to Israel and May Ulert. Italy's Giorgia Caglioni. All the way from Japan, Yuria Mochizuku. Latvia, Antsiekia Ceder. Lithuania's Mekla Konsineda. Followed by Malta, Riona Manicaro. Representing Monaco, Aurora Sartori. And from the Netherlands, Jorissa van Leunten. New Zealand's Olivia Ross. Welcome back to Norway's Julia Bjerklund. And from Poland, Sara Pienskorsa. Portugal now, with Margarita Santos representing the country. Welcome back to Russia's Anna Goriseva. And Slovakia's Kristina Monková. Welcome back to Anna Gaisier from Slovenia. And South Africa's Shay Wright. E viva España from Spain, Andrea Gonzalez. And from Sweden, Selma Mortensson. Switzerland, Gwendolyn Geyer. All the way from the United Kingdom, Min Witheman. Welcome to our new country, the Ukraine, Ksenia Yarmolenko. And contestant number 42, our final contestant from the United States of America, Claire Stebor. So with just Thailand missing, we have 41 of the 42 competitors entered. And Jason's going to take his initial look around these outstanding junior handlers. And while he does, let me take this opportunity to talk a little bit more about this exciting first round. At 8:30 this morning, each handler met their dog for the very first time. So unbelievably, they've had just a couple of hours, not that even, bonding time before facing Jason's critical eye here at Crufts in this superb main arena. Jason tells me he's looking for each dog to be shown correctly for its own breed requirements. Without any exaggeration, he feels that the handlers need to be in control, but not obviously apparent in their motions, working as a team all of the time. As I said, we have one new country this year, so a warm welcome to Ukraine. Laskovo Promiso, Ukraine. We have 40 girls and just one boy in this year's event. There are 12 returning finalists, 8 coming back for the second time, 2 for the third time, and 2 for an incredible fourth appearance here at Crufts. So as Jason comes to the end of his first look at the finalists, please put your hands together for the future of our sport. He will now put each of these finalists through their paces, starting with our first finalist, all the way from down under. Welcome to 18-year-old Destiny Hamilton, representing Australia. Always difficult to be the first one. Jason's going to give them each the same amount of time and the same quizzical eye. Destiny is 18. This is her first time at Crufts, handling an Australian Shepherd. She lives at home with 2 Dobermans. This is Destiny representing Australia. When she's not handling dogs, she's a keen photographer. So well done to the first of our finalists, Destiny from Australia. Jason now turns his attention to Jana Hoffer. Welcome back for the second time. Jana was here in 2016. She's handling a Siberian Husky, representing Austria, 16 years old. At home, her dogs of choice are the Border Terrier and miniature Schnauzer. Jana also competes in Canicross when she's not showing the dogs in the main ring. This is Jana Hoffer representing Austria. Now the only lad in our competition representing Belarus, a warm welcome please to Yuri Kherbachuk. Yuri is 18 years old, has a tough act to follow because Belarus have won this competition with Dasha Moiseva back a few years ago. Yuri tells me he hopes to follow in Dasha's footsteps. At home, Yuri has Yorkshire Terriers, Russian Toys and a Chihuahua, but has chosen a flat coat for the competition today. Favourite subjects at school are biology and English. A warm welcome to Yuri Kherbovchuk, representing Belarus. Now we have three 12-year-old competitors, and this is the first of our 12-year-olds. Amazing, they're so skilled at such an early age. This is Gita Lux, representing Belgium. Chosen a Bull Mastiff to handle in this competition. She lives at home with four Bull Mastiffs and one pup. As well as handling dogs, Gita loves horse riding and is keen on drawing, and also has rabbits and chickens at home that she looks after. Gita Lux, representing Belgium. So this is Brazil. Welcome to Katarina Oriki. Katarina is 15 years old. This is only the second time that Brazil have been here at Crafts, and the last time was 10 years ago when they won the competition. Katarina tells me she's very much hoping to make it second time for Brazil. Interestingly, handling an old English sheepdog, a breed that won the World Challenge here on our opening day at Crufts. Katarina is interested in veterinary medicine. Lives at home with Pomeranians, Schnauzers, Pug, a Dachshund, and of course, three of her own old English sheepdogs. Katarina Oreki from Brazil. We turn our attention now to Bulgaria. Welcome to Elena Stoyeva. Elena, 16 years old, handling a Bracco Italiano. Only been handling dogs for 4 years. Had lots of success at her home country of Bulgaria. She enjoys biology and the arts. Elena tells me that she'd like to be an interior designer when she's finished her education, or a professional handler. Elena Stoyeva, representing Bulgaria. All the way from Canada. This is 14-year-old Kayla Penny. Kayla's handling a Portuguese water dog, another interesting breed to choose. She lives at home with her own Portuguese water dog called Cash. interested in medicine, whether it's human or veterinary medicine, she hasn't quite decided yet. Also involved in rally obedience at home in Canada. Keen snowboarder. Currently learning how to play the guitar. Kayla Penny, representing Canada. One of our most experienced competitors, this is Carla Ivancic, representing Croatia here for the fourth time, although she's qualified five times, unfortunately couldn't manage to get here on that last occasion. Carla's 18 years old. Handling a Siberian Husky, lives at home with Schnauzers, two standard Schnauzers and two miniature Schnauzers. Another of our youngsters who thinks that her future lays in the veterinarian profession. Keen swimmer. And windsurfer too. This is Croatia's Carla Ivancic. So another of our 12-year-old competitors, handling an Irish setter. This is Nikola Zlamalova, representing the Czech Republic. At home, Nikola lives with three Irish setters. She's been practicing and handling for a very long time, she tells me, literally as soon as she could walk. 10 years. Her favorite subject at school is physical education, and she's a keen gymnast. A warm welcome to Cross for Nikola, representing the Czech Republic. And from the Czech Republic, we move to Denmark. This is Camille Erbeck, 16 years old, handling a Samoyed. Although she doesn't have any dogs at home, as her mother's allergic to dogs, she practices regularly borrowing and showing breeds such as Samoyeds, English Springers, and Cardigan Corgis. Favorite subject at school is English. She's very fluent in English, as she proved last night at our fabulous dinner. Another of our youngsters who would be interested in becoming a veterinary nurse. Loves working with animals of all sorts. Camille Erbeck, representing Denmark. Estonia now. This is Yekaterina Boyka. Yekaterina is 16 years old, handling an English Springer Spaniel. She has two dogs at home, both black Labrador retrievers. Labradors were the biggest single entry for the judge of the bitches here, Sissy Wiles from Sweden, on our opening day. Over 300 Labradors, bitches alone. Over 500 for the breed in total, just behind the Golden Retriever, which was the single biggest joint entry. I wonder whether Ekaterina watched the judging of the Labradors here, that she's chosen an English Springer to handle in the competition. Keen chemist, also very good at maths, she tells me. Not quite decided what Ekaterina wants to be when she finally finishes studies. One more time, representing Estonia, Ekaterina Boyka. Now it's the turn of the pointer, handled ably by Lotta Nikkonen. Lotta's representing Finland, and she's 16 years old. Lotta became interested in dogs as her mother is a major breeder of Staffordshire Bull Terriers at home in Finland. At school, she's very interested in chemistry, biology and history, and natural science. As well as enjoying the handling side of our sport, Lotta tells me that one day she aspires to become a judge. Lotta Nikkonen, representing Finland. So on to the table now. Jason turns his attention to the American Cocker Spaniel. Welcome back. Will it be third time lucky for Elaine Tongy, representing France? Elaine is 16 years old. Lives at home with Belgian Shepherd dog Malinois, German Shepherds, Staffordshire Bull Terriers, Yorkshire Terriers, and a Chihuahua. Quite a busy household there back in France. This is Elaine Tongy representing France. Not only successful in showing her dogs, Elaine also shows and is involved with parrots and bird shows too back in France. Elaine Tongy. Another English Springer Spaniel, this time handled by Johanna Sieger, representing Germany. Johanna's 18 years old, and she tells me she has 8 dogs at home, 5 Pharaohs, 2 Rhodesian Ridgebacks, and a Whippet. Johanna enjoys agility competition as well as handling and showing dogs. Her favorite subject at school is German. Keen sports person too, quite an athlete. Johanna Sieger representing Germany. On the table now we see a Japanese Shiba Inu. This is Emily Feek representing Gibraltar for the second time. Emily is 17 years old.
another of our competitors who's involved in agility as well as showmanship and handling. Emily's favourite subjects at school are maths and physics. Enjoys reading, travelling and hiking. A warm Crufts welcome, one more time please, for Emily Feek representing Gibraltar. Another contestant back here for the second time, Katerina Yanou, was here in 2017 representing Greece. Katerina is 15 years old. Handling a greyhound. At home, she lives with three Akitas. Quite a linguist, Katerina. She's learning Chinese, French, and English. She enjoys cooking Asian dishes, dancing, playing the piano, and reading. Will it be second time lucky for Katerina, representing Greece? Hungary's representative is Nicolette Rosman. Nicolette is 18 years old. This is her first time at Crufts. She's chosen a breed from her native Hungary, the Hungarian Vizsla. At home, Nicolette lives with eight dogs, quite a mixture, Boston Terriers, Hungarian Greyhound, a German Shepherd, a Fox Terrier, and three mixed breed dogs. Nicolette's favorite subject at school is biology. She enjoys the wild life. When she finishes her study, she thinks she may continue along the biology scene with veterinary studies. Isn't quite determined exactly what she will be when she finishes, but always wants to keep her involvement with dogs, thoroughly enjoys her showing. This is Nicolette Rosman representing Hungary. So Jason now turns his attention to Vaka. Vaka is from Iceland, Vaka Viodisdottir. She's 16 years old, and this is Vaka's second time here on the green carpet in the big ring at Crufts. Handling a pointer. At home she lives with an Afghan hound and a Briard. Interested in sociology, history and biology. When she's not involved with dogs, Vaka tells me, she spends her free time with friends and family, hiking, snowboarding in the Icelandic mountains. This is Iceland's Vaka Fjörðisdóttir. handling an English setter. Welcome to Sarah Cushley, representing Ireland. Sarah is 16 years old, lives at home with a Saluki and a German Shepherd. Started showing just 3 years ago. Has enjoyed some major success in Ireland and hopes to continue that successful career in showing dogs here today at Crufts. Sarah tells me she thinks she'd like to become a veterinary nurse when she's finished her studies, but she enjoys sailing and is also involved in the school hockey team. Representing the Emerald Isle, Sarah Cushley. So we're almost halfway through the competition here. And this is May Ullert, representing Israel. May's 17-year-old is handling a Dalmatian. She has three dogs, a Cane Corso and two Shih Tzu. May tells me that she would like to become a veterinarian when she finishes her studies. Also a keen cook, enjoys baking particularly. Welcome to May Ullert, representing Israel. And for those of you who have just joined the arena, this is the exciting International Junior Handling Competition, 41 future All-Stars trying to win the coveted title of International Junior Handler of the Year. So this is contestant number 21. Welcome to Giorgia Caglioni, representing Italy. Giorgia, handling a Gordon setter, lives at home in Italy with four wire-haired Dachshunds, two standards and two miniatures. Started handling 8 years ago. Favorite subjects at school are psychology and English. Giorgia tells me she would like to become a psychologist or a speech therapist when she's finished her studies. Italy's Giorgia Caglioni. All the way from Japan. A warm Crufts welcome for Yuria Mochizuku. Yuria is handling a native breed dog, a Japanese Shiba Inu. At home, she has 10 dogs, slightly smaller varieties, Chihuahuas and Shih Tzus. Currently in the 10th grade of her education, her favorite subject at school is art. when she's not involved with showing her dogs. Yuri is also interested in horses and riding. Very keen on animation and computer video games. Yuria, representing Japan. Welcome back for the second time to Latvia's Anser Gertzaner. Anser is 14 years old, handling a Samoyed, the breed that won the pastoral group here yesterday on Fabulous Friday, Crofts 2019. Lives at home with a Cavalier King Charles and a Rottweiler. Quite a combination of dogs there. At school, he's very keen on art and housekeeping. Inspired by crafts and work. Another keen and budding chef. This is Anser Gertzaner, representing Latvia. Jason now turns his attention to Lithuania's Megla Kosinaitė. Megla is 17 years old, another Gordon setter. At home she lives with a Bernese Mountain Dog. Only been handling dogs for 4 years. Had huge success in Lithuania. Very excited to be here on the green carpet at Crofts. Megla's interested in history at school. She thinks it's important to know what's gone on in the past and how it's affected the future. Megla Kosinaitė, representing Lithuania. Fourteen-year-old Riona Manikaro, delighted to be representing Malta. Handling an English setter, Riona lives at home with Border Collies, Beagles, Basenjis and Cavaliers. She lives at home in Malta on a farm, but confidently tells me she's just involved with the dogs on the farm, not the other animals. Loves reading, and she's finished her schooling. She hopes to become a professional handler. Malta, Riona Manikaro. Now we see a standard poodle handled by Aurora Sartori, representing Monaco. Aurora is just 14 years old. Lives at home with 10 dogs. Australian cattle dogs, a standard poodle, a miniature poodle, an Afghan, a Pomeranian, just to mention a few. Favorite subjects are maths, geometry, English, art, and technology. Aurora is interested in art and painting. He is a keen player of volleyball. Aurora Sartori representing Monaco. And from the Netherlands now, this is Jorissa van Lenter. Jorissa is 18 years old and has chosen Abraco Italiano, to handle in the competition. Jorissa lives at home with a Shetland sheepdog. Also a keen horse rider, loves all equestrian sports as well as the world of dogs. When she's older, she feels that she wants to be involved in property and estate management. Very keen on fitness and horse riding too. Jorissa from the Netherlands. And a 24-hour journey from New Zealand. Welcome to Olivia Ross. Olivia is 17, handling a pointer in the competition. Is at home with 5 Hungarian Vishlas, 4 Braco Italianos, and 3 smooth-haired Dachshunds. And as the arena fills up, I think it's important to say, just one more time, these youngsters only met these dogs an hour and a half ago, so they've had very little chance to practice and bond with them, but what a great job they're doing. Give them all one big round of applause, please. So, Olivia Ross, representing New Zealand. Interested in art design and history. Very creative person. As well as handling dogs, Olivia loves playing netball. And a keen and budding photographer too. Olivia Ross from New Zealand. So, welcome back to Julia Bjørklund from Norway. No stranger to crafts, this is Julia's 4th consecutive year. She was a finalist here last year and hopes to go just that one bit further. Julia's last chance in this competition. She's 18 years old, handling a German wire-haired pointer. Lives at home with 5 Samoyeds. So Jason, our judge, tells each individual competitor what he's looking for and what to do. So, triangle here for Julia, with her German wire-haired pointer. Julia tells me she is interested in music and particularly composing. Taking singing classes as well. Round you go. This is Julia Bjørklund representing Norway. Three quarters of the way through the competition. We turn our attention now to Poland. This is Sara Pienkowska. Sara, 16 years old, very, very excited to be here at Crafts. I'm very proud to be representing Poland. Handling an English Springer Spaniel at home. She has 6 white Swiss Shepherd dogs and 3 long-haired Chihuahuas. Favourite subjects at school are biology and geography. Sara Pienkowska, representing Poland. Last year's winner came from Portugal. A tough act to follow, but will it be a double 2-year running win for Portugal? This is Margarida dos Santos, 17-year-old, hoping to follow the success of last year's junior handling winner. Margarida's handling a German shorthaired pointer, lives at home with a Braco, a Griffon Bruxellois, and 3 Petit Brabançons. Another person here who's interested in psychology. When she finishes her studies, she tells me she wants to join the police to work with dogs. You mustn't get on the wrong side of Margarida, because she's a very keen kickboxer too. Good luck to Margarida dos Santos, representing Portugal. Jason now turns his attention to Russia's Anna Goryunova. Anna's just 14 years old. This is her second year here at Crafts, handling an Australian Shepherd. Along with her parents, who have a budding kennel. They have 20 dogs, a Samoyeds, English Pointers, Corgis, and Huskies. In the 8th grade of elementary school in Moscow, favorite subjects are history and biology. So, second time lucky perhaps for Russia, Anna Goryunova. Kristina Munková, representing Slovakia with a Tibetan Terrier, 16 years old, so excited to be here at Crafts in the big ring. Kristina lives at home with a rescue dog, and his name's Basti. Only started handling dogs 1.5 years ago, and she's made it here to Crafts. That's some achievement. Another biology student here. one of the subjects that I just couldn't get along with when I was at school many, many moons ago. And she's not handling her dogs. Christina tells me she loves skiing and playing the violin. Well done, taking the time to make sure the dog is settled. Just goes to show these youngsters have to know how to handle and coax and persuade the dogs to do what they want them to do. It's not only difficult sometimes for the handlers, whether young or old, in this big ring. It's a big ring, lots of noises, and some of these dogs, you know, they do find it sometimes overawing, but handled correctly, they can make it. There you go. Well done to Christina from Slovakia. Second year here too for Slovenia's Anna Geitzer. Anna is 16 years old, handling a giant schnauzer. She has two dogs at home, Cane Corsos. Enjoys history and English at school. Excited to be back for the second chance here at Crufts. Anna would love to become a professional handler. Also interested in genetics and the breeding of dogs. In her free time, she enjoys playing volleyball. This is Anna, representing Slovenia. Welcome back for the second time to South Africa's Shay Wright. Shay is 17 years old, handling an Irish setter. Shay lives in the Midrand area of South Africa. Lives at home with 6 Hungarian pullies and 10 bearded collies. Shay tells me she also is interested in psychology. When she's not studying or handling dogs, she enjoys competing with her horses too. Keen show jumper, also enjoys debates and athletics. So it's the Irish setter handled by Shay Wright from South Africa. Will it be third time lucky for Andrea Gonzalez, representing Spain? Andrea's Irish setter, 17 years old, lives at home with springers, cockers, Andalusian podengos, and a pointer. At the amazing international dinner last night, Andrea showed us how talented she was and sang us an amazing song. Keen on singing, music, interpretation, a real passion alongside her handling of dogs. I'm sure if she wins this competition, she'll sing us a song this evening. Buena suerte to Spain, Andrea González. So from Spain, we move to Sweden. Welcome to Selma Mortensson. Selma, 17 years old, handling a bearded collie, lives at home with an Australian shepherd, an English setter, a beardie, and two Swedish elkhounds. Interested in economics and history. When she's not handling dogs, she's enjoying skiing, especially downhill skiing. But I don't think you can ski uphill, can you? Shopping, just hanging out and chilling with her friends. Well done to Selma Mortensson, representing Sweden. Another of our 12-year-old competitors, quite incredible. 12 years of age to win through from Switzerland. This is Gwendolyn Geyer. Handling an Australian Shepherd. Gwendolyn lives at home with three Bedlington Terriers. There you go. Been handling for 5 years. Enjoys drawing and cooking. And hopes to make cooking part of her future career as well as handling dogs. Gwendolyn, representing Switzerland. Gwendolyn Geyer. Representing Switzerland, just 12 years old. So as our Thai competitor unfortunately had to withdraw, we move on to contestant number 40. The United Kingdom's Min Withyman. Min is 18 years old, chosen a pointer to handle in the competition. At home, she lives with four soft-coated Wheatons and a German Shepherd. Keen on law at school, finds crime, particularly historical cases, incredibly interesting. Min tells me she'd like to travel the world, especially the United States, to improve her very able handling skills. When she's not handling, she plays badminton and squash and plays the piano. I'm sure if she wins tonight, she'll be playing a tune all the way home. Min Withyman from the United Kingdom. Laskovo Prosimo, Ukraine. A new country. First time here for Ukraine. And welcome to Ksenia Yermolenko. Ksenia, 15 years old, so proud to be the first representative of her country, Ukraine, handling a Gordon Setter, and she lives with two Gordon Setters at home. Enjoys photography. Loves playing football. as well as the guitar, but never wants to stop her involvement with dogs. Our new country, Ukraine, represented very ably by Kirsteneia Yermolenko. So Jason turns his attention to the representative from the United States of America. Welcome to Claire Stebor. Handling an English springer, Claire is 18 years old. Claire lives with Brittany's, Irish Setters, Chinese Crested, Tibetan Spaniels, and an English Springer that she's chosen to handle in this competition tonight. One that I said earlier, these youngsters only met their dogs at 8:30 this morning. And quite incredible they've done to achieve the unison and bonding that you're seeing in front of you. Quite incredible talent we have in front of us. Claire's so excited to be here, all the way from the United States. Always dreamed of being able to show in the big ring here at Crufts, especially on Super Saturday. Oh, I see she wants to be a special agent in the FBI, so we'll have to keep on the right side of Claire. Round you go. Put your hands together for the last of the individual examinations. Claire Stebor from the United States of America. So that concludes the first round and individual assessment of the 41 superb international junior handling finalists. Now Jason must take a very slow and considered look at each of these 41. We're ahead of time, which allows him to really consider what he's seen, because these 41 have done a super job. But it doesn't end here. We're going to be back later this morning for round two. Well, all 41 of these exhibitors at 12:10 will have to come back in to this big ring with a new dog that they'll have only had an hour at the maximum to practice with. Jason then puts them through their paces one more time. I need now, as he looks around the ring, to say a few thank yous. A thank you to the competitors, to our judge, but more importantly to the people who have lent us these dogs, the breeders who have lent us this dog, come here and given up a Saturday. Put your hands together, please, because without the breeders bringing these super dogs in, we couldn't have the competition that you're seeing. It's so, so well appreciated. Thank you. A big thank you to our organisers, Liz Cartledge, Irene Terry, Val Kumsty, Maureen Reynolds, also ably assisted by our last year's judge in the ring, Yanis Vlahos. It's time also to thank our sponsors, the armbands produced by Fostata, generous support from our dogs and Birdbrook rosettes, and of course, the Kennel Club. Last night, these 41 international juniors were welcomed to Crufts with a gala dinner where they were able to meet and exchange and wish each other good luck. It's really a most amazing sight to see the enthusiasm and the friendliness and the friendship amongst these competitors. Each of the competitors stood up and spoke in amazing English to wish their fellow competitors the very best of luck today. So we're on day three of Crufts, superb television coverage on Channel 4 this evening. Over 20,000 dogs here at Crufts over the 4 days. We have three finalists. From day one, the Irish Water Spaniel topped the Gundog group. And last night, if you were here, you may well have seen the Boxer win the working group and the Samoyed win the pastoral group. Tonight, we'll be judging the Hound group and the Terrier group. In the second round, which starts in just over an hour's time, Jason will not only look at these 41 competitors, slightly briefer look, and will then determine how they've handled their second dog, and will make a secret shortlist of 10, just 10 grand finalists for the grand finale later on this afternoon here in the big ring at Crufts, 5:45. Well, their 10 finalists will then be put through their final paces with their initial dog, and three will be selected. The second runner-up, the first runner-up, and the winner. Who do you think it'll be? Well, there's only one man who's going to be able to tell us that, and that will be our judge, Jason Hope. So we've come to the end of the round. Put your hands together. What a great job today as they leave the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much indeed. Keep the applause going. Out you go, girls. Round you go.
International dog agility coming up. Lots happening in the arena all day today. There is something happening on Sunday evening during Best in Show that's very important as well. It's called Friends for Life. You've probably seen it in previous years. And we're going to show you a short video with all the candidates on it. And you really should take note, folks, because we need your votes. If you decide which one you'd like to put your vote with, which candidate, then please do go online and vote. It's very important. And it's going to be great to see it unveiled on Sunday night. Anyway, here's the video. Just take it all
in. So Amir Ransa, been deployed just once to Afghanistan, but we've also been teamed up for 4 years prior to that. My name's Private Hampson, and this is my military working dog, Lance. When I came back, I was got reposted, so I was going to leave Germany to go out to Cyprus, and Lance wasn't going to come with me, so I had to try and argue and persuade my sergeant major to release him, to let him come out with me. So then he managed to come out with me and got to share another experience with me dog before he retired. I'd describe Lance as a very mellow and chilled out character. He's loving but loves working as well.
Working hard.
Training that me and Lance went through for the start was, so I finished my AS course in 2014, November, and I had to select a dog to go on to Afghan with. And I got wind of Lance last minute. We clicked straight away. Our bond came really close once we started working together, and we got more jobs fired our way because of like how good we worked as a team. So, like, we always get told like the dog's always a bit of kit, but obviously when you start loving the dog and the amount of hours and time and effort you put into the dog, you can't see the dog in that way. As well as searching and help find weapons and explosives, he also boosts the morale and the spirit of the whole team. When he came up to retirement, and he's worked hard for like servicemen and women, and he worked hard overseas in Afghanistan, and he's my best friend. It's my turn to give something back to him.
See you again. When I first got him, although I knew he was a blood donor, I didn't think he would be as loving and as sociable as he is. Hi, my name is Sarah, and this is my rescue dog, Ringo. On a day of donation, we get up, I walk the dogs as normal, then get them ready. When we get there,
he comes in, we put clip a little area of hair on his neck over his jugular vein, which is where we take the blood from, and then we just insert a needle and he donates a pint of blood for us. Once he's done, we just lift him down and give him a bowl of food and water.
It's just amazing knowing that animals can save lives as humans can with blood.
I'd say Ringo is probably the perfect donor for us because each donation can go to at least two patients, but probably much more than that. And temperament-wise, he's always happy to be here. He lies perfectly still on the table, so he's perfect.
The Royal Veterinary College do get thank you letters, which they always forward on. So it's really nice to see occasionally when we get that email from the recipient of the blood with a thank you note. And it's just a lovely feeling. He's changed our lives. He and I have that bond that I feel is a very special bond, and he's made me so proud. He's changed his own life by coming into a home, and also all those donations that he's done and the impact that he will have had on other animals' lives. He's just one in a million. He really is.
When I was really young, my mum said, "Do you want a dog?" And I said yes. And then we suddenly were driving to go get a dog. I felt like Snoopy was just the perfect dog, and I really wanted him because he was really cute. My name's Ollie and this is Snoopy. I like to cuddle him, I like to feed him, and also, especially, I like playing football with him. Yeah, he's my best friend, really.
Ollie became really, really poorly. He was diagnosed with acute lymphoblastemic leukemia. You know, Ollie was 3.5. And then they told us that the treatment for leukemia was 3.5 years. He was unable to see friends and family. It was like, wow, that's a lot of his childhood that's been spent in hospital. Snoopy's just been the constant friend that Ollie couldn't have anywhere else, really, because he had to learn to crawl and then he had to learn to walk again. And Snoopy helped him because he had to go out for a walk. I think that encouraged Ollie to be able to, you know, put some more effort into learning to walk again.
I kind of feel like he wants me to be able to run with him, so that's why I want to be able to run with him. Even if I was in a wheelchair, I still got to walk him.
I always hoped that they would be best friends, but I never, ever in my entire life really thought that they would have the bond that they do together. And I think, you know, it's just a constant friend, always there, no matter what, really. Wherever Ollie is, Snoopy is never far behind. Their bond has just been amazing. He kind of follows him everywhere. It's almost like his protector, really.
He normally cuddles up next to me without me asking him. So that kind of tells me that he's my best friend.
Millie would be very quiet. She would have her head down and be really withdrawn. She's got Down syndrome, she's got pulmonary hypertension, low muscle tone and anxiety. Since having Emma, she's totally changed. As long as she's got Emma in the vicinity, she's great. It's really given her so much more confidence. The worries that we had before we got Emma was that Millie would be kind of left on her own. She wouldn't have a companion. Millie was really scared of dogs. When we went to Dogs for Good, Millie was playing on the climbing frame. We were dropping treats down the slide to Emma. On the way home, she said, "I like that doggy, Daddy. She's nice and fluffy," which then started their bond and their journey together. Which one's your favourite dog?
Emma. She's my favourite.
She is your favourite. Emma and Millie are very coordinated already. They're just growing all the time together. She's really in tune with Millie. Their personalities are quite similar. They like their quiet time and that they love to play. They really interact really well. Millie comes home from school. First person she goes to is Emma, straight past Dad, past everyone. Emma gives her hugs. What do you do when you come home and see Emma? What do you do with her?
I cuddle her.
Do you give her big cuddles or little cuddles?
Big cuddles, like this.
Emma can open doors for Millie. Millie has medication in her drinks. Millie will leave them in places. We don't know where they are. We ask Emma. Emma will go and find it and bring it back to us.
What sort of tricks does she do?
She gets my cup.
She gets your cup.
Emma will go up and do a headrest on her when she's out of breath. She just supports her in so many different ways.
Yeah.
As Millie grows, having Emma beside her, it's given me and Chris a sense of comfort to know that she's always got a best friend in Emma. And just seeing them grow together is something that we're really looking forward to. She just pulls the whole family together somehow. She, like we all go out for walks, even when it's pouring with rain, we'll all be out having a walk together. I think she just helps the whole family just become more of a unit with the bond that Millie and Emma have got together and just the way it's been growing. It's been fantastic.
Do you love your doggy?
Mm.
Okay, coming up very shortly, we have the Lowland Rescue team coming into the arena. So we've also got the Southern Golden Retriever display team as well, followed by the International Junior Handling Competition Part 2. And I have the pleasure of introducing Lou from the Lowland Rescue. And she's going to give you basically a display about, or they're going to give you a display, the training of the search and rescue dogs and how they train their dogs for search and rescue.
I love it out here. I understand the draw of the outdoors and I understand what can go wrong.
I join because I like knowing that if a member of my family were out there, there'd be somebody to help me find them and I get to work with my best friend. The call came in early on a Friday. A man was missing near Oxford. Beau and I were in the car in 5 minutes.
I remember it was cold. I was in winter gear, inside the control van, and I could still feel it. To do this job, you have to be an optimist. Missing 9 days in that weather, it was hard to believe we'd find him in time. After 2 days, we'd searched over 15 square kilometers with no luck. The odds of finding him were pretty low.
The next morning was Mother's Day, but we went out one last time, mostly to finish the search right. We were looking further west of where he was supposed to be, in the middle of this field where we thought for sure he'd have been spotted by a helicopter. But Bo took off like a shot, heading straight for this embankment.
I was back home with my family, monitoring the radio traffic on Wave. I heard the priority call that he was found. Hypothermic, but alive. I called in the emergency services to their location and got him airlifted to a hospital.
Even if I never find someone again, the training, the hours, the sacrifice will be worth it. A man is alive because of us. A family is together.
His niece came by afterwards. She was crying, but she looked me in the eye and thanked me for saving his life.
That was a really good Mother's Day. Bo got a pouch of cat food. He loves it. He's a hero. He can eat what he wants.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Lou. I'm here with my colleagues in the arena this morning to show you a demonstration of our search and rescue dogs. So as you saw from the VT in the slides, Lowland Rescue is a completely volunteer search and rescue organisation. We deploy on behalf of the police and the other emergency services to search for high-risk missing people. We have 36 Lowland Rescue teams in the UK, which consist of over 1,800 members who provide a variety of life-saving services from search to water and everything in between. What we're going to show you here today is a little bit of a demonstration of the work that the search dogs do. We're going to show you how we start off their training up through through the grades to how we get the end picture. So when you think of a search and rescue dog, you're probably thinking about a dog searching on a hillside, lost walkers. In Lowland Rescue, we operate in different environments to that, typically parks, heathlands, open forestry, not on the mountains, which means that the type of missing person that we're looking for is also a little bit different. Generally, the vast majority of our call-outs are for people who are suffering with Alzheimer's or living with dementia and who may have become confused and wandered. All of the dogs and the handlers that you see today are all completely volunteers. We don't charge for any of our services. All the time that we give is given freely. And the dogs are all pets first and foremost, and they work alongside us in the search and rescue. So we have a variety of different dogs here today. Across all the different teams, we've got loads of different dogs, Jack Russells, gun dogs, Labradors, Spaniels, Collies. We've got a Cockapoo here today with us. But it really doesn't matter what type of dog you've got. We can work with them and train them for this work. So we're going to show you today the first stages, first of all, of how the dogs start. So you can see that the dogs on the sides are playing a game of piggy in the middle. So this is just to get the dogs used to running backwards and forwards between the two people. Because in the end, what we want the dogs to do is to find the person, tell us that they found them, and take us back to that person. So the dogs are just getting used to running between people, getting their rewards from different people. It might be the handler, or it might be the person who's acting as their body. The next stage from this is that the dogs will move on to do what we call a scene runaway. So you're going to see the handlers hold the dogs. The person who's pretending to be our missing person, so our dog's body, is going to wind the dog up with the toy. The dog's going to see where the person is going, and then the handler will let the dog go, and the dog will run to that person and get its reward once it's found its person. Now, obviously, this is a very set-up situation. We're not out in woods and things here. So for the benefits of this, we're just using our little hides so that the dogs can go backwards and forwards into the hide. Once the dogs are confidently going and finding the people from that seen runaway, we move on to doing an unseen runaway. So the dogs will be turned around so they don't see where the person's going. And once the person's hidden, the handler will send them to go and find that person. And we build this up in as many different places as we can, using as many different people as we can as the volunteers who are hiding, so that the dogs get used to finding everybody, children, males, females, anybody who we ask them to go and find, and a variety of different people. So once they've done their unseen runaways, the next thing that we need to teach the dogs to do is to do what we call an alert. So we're going to swap some dogs around a little bit, and our people are going to stay hidden. And the dogs that come out next are going to show you a variety of different alerts. So when the dogs have found people, often they can be a long way away from us, so we won't know that the dog has necessarily found. So the dog needs to have some way of telling us that it's found. So starting with Jan over here with Gus. Jan, if you give us a wave. There she is. She's going to show a bark alert. So Gus will go and find his person. Once he's found his person, he's going to come back to Jan and bark at her to tell her that he's found somebody. And then as you can see, Jan gives him a lovely, nice reward so that he's got his reward for doing the alert. Well done, Jan. Oh, he's found another person. All right, now next we're going to have Rich and Sasse. Rich is going to work. Sasse, who's the little border collie over there at the end, is going to give us a little wave. Sasse does a different type of alert. So she's going to find her person. She'll then come back to Rich and jump up at him to tell him that she has found her person. So we'll let him show that one. Good girl. I say, so once she jumps up again, she gets her reward for performing that behavior. And the way that we choose the alerts is a little bit led by handler preference and also what the dogs do themselves naturally in the earlier stage of the training. Some dogs get quite excited and bark. Some dogs will jump up and sort of, oh, look, I found. So we work with the dogs a little bit to develop their type of alert. Now, Otto, the Labrador over there with Ro, he's got a different alert again. So he's got what's known as a bring cell alert. So you might be able to see that hanging down from his collar, he's got a little blue tape that's going to hang down from his collar while he's working. Once he's found his person, he will pick that up and hold it in his mouth so that Ro will know that he has found his person. He's going to go and find the people outside. He says it's a little bit too easy. It's a little bit too easy for Otto the super dog. So you could see that once he'd been out there and found whoever it was that he found out there, they don't know that they're being found, but he doesn't know who he's looking for. He's just working on air scent. He picked up his little tag that hangs down and carried that back in his mouth, and again, Ro rewarded him for doing that. So next, we're going to have Jophie and Maya, and she is over here, so she's going to whip us away from under the little Crufts sign. Now, Maya is a bark at the missing person, so she's going to come and find her person in the hide, and then she's going to stay with them and bark. And she'll stay barking until her handler gets there so that she can come along and then help the misper as she needs to. Brilliant. Okay, so next we're going to show you the process in full. So once the dogs have found their person, They've come back, they've alerted us to the fact that they've found that person. They then need to take us back to the person. So the handler and the support person who's with them will then be able to give any medical attention or get help and backup if it's needed to the missing person. So we're going to go around, and we're going to do it one at a time again. So we're going to start off over here with Alan and Rusty, the Labrador. Alan, if you give us a little wave. So Alan is going to go, let Rusty go. Rusty's going to go and find the person. Ooh. And once he's found his person, he will do his alert. He also is a bring cell alert. So he'll pick up his little tag. You can see he's got it in his mouth. And then Alan will ask him where the person is, and he takes him straight back. So this links back a little bit to the piggy in the middle exercise that we were doing before, where the dogs were getting used to running backwards and forwards between the people. That gets them used to getting their reward sometimes from the missed person, sometimes from the handler. So that was really well done. So Sassy and Rich are going to show us again. So she's going to do her alert, and this time she's going to take Rich back to the person. Good girl, Sassy. She can have a round of applause. She's a very good girl. And then next up, we've got John and Isla. So Isla is a jump alert. So she's going to find her person, come back, jump up, and take John back to them. She says, come on, Dad, you can see that the person's there. I'm not stupid. Good girl. And then over here we've got Bridget, so she's going to let go and come and find, and we'll see if we can spot what type of alert they do. There we go, another jumper. Yay, well done, brilliant. Well done, everybody, that's brilliant. Okay, so that's a little overview of the air scenting dogs. Obviously, we have to use a little bit of imagination that this is a large, vast area. There's woodland, there's brambles, there's all kinds of things, rather than just a field with a few tents in it. But the air scenting dogs are looking for any human scent. So what we're going to show you now is the ground scenting dogs, or the trailing dogs. Now, these are dogs that are trained to find a specific scent of a person. So we're going to move everybody to the side. Jan's going to switch dogs, and she's going to fetch in a little border collie called Diesel. And what we're going to do is we're going to line some people up with me in the middle of the ring. I'm going to take my jacket with me, and I'm going to pop this down over here. And Diesel will come in, he'll have a little bit of a sniff of this, and that will give him the scent of me. It's my jacket, I've been wearing it all morning. So we're going to pop it down, so he'll be able to smell me. And then we're going to line up, and he's going to go and sniff each person, and hopefully, when he finds me, he will stay with me. He won't go on to the next person. He will want to stay with me, and he will alert Jan to the fact that, oh, he's found me, and that's the right scent. So she's going to bring him in. She needs to let him smell the article so that he can get in his head which scent it is that he's looking for. So he'll have a little sniff of that, and then he'll come along the people, probably have a little sniff at their hands and things, get the smell of the person. And then when he's found the right person, you can see he's in no rush to go anywhere. So we will then reward him for doing that. Okay, so you could see that he had no hesitation. He knew that that was me. He stayed with me and didn't want to move on to our next person because he knew that, okay, this is the person that I'm looking for. So we're going to move out of the way now. We're going to see, we're going to show you how we develop that into the next stage of that, of where it's useful for that if we know where a person has gone missing from. So if they're a person who's a little bit confused, maybe they've wandered out of their home or their care home, they've gone missing from there, we can take one of our trailing dogs, give them an article that belongs to that person. And as you've seen, Diesel could smell the specific scent of me. So we're going to bring in next Bert, who is a black and tan coonhound. Sarah here is going to drop her jumper, so she's going to drop her scent article, and she's walking off across the arena. And she's laying a trail as she goes that is all coming off her, a little bit of ground disturbance, scent coming off from skin rafts that are coming off her. And they're creating a picture to Bert of where she's walked. So Bert will be able to come in. He'll sniff Sarah's jacket to get the scent that he is working. And then hopefully he will follow the trail where she's walked pretty perfectly. As you can see, he's got his nose down on the floor working. The ground scent dogs work on long lines with their noses down. The air scenting dogs from earlier worked very much on the air and the wind. And once he gets to Sarah, he'll then stay with her so Simon can get to the end of the lead and give him his reward. Well done, Bert. Brilliant, fantastic. So you got there a little picture of the different types of dogs that we do. We do have dogs that work on boats, on water, who can find people that have drowned in water as well. But hopefully that's given you a little bit of an overview of the work that we do. We have got a stand in Hall 3, stand 110. We've got loads of free goodie bags. So if you want to find out a little bit more about the work that we do, or you want to come and grab a goodie bag that's got things for you and your dog in it, then pop up there and visit us. But I'm going to get everybody to just do a little lap of honour. You can give them a nice big round of applause. And thank you all very much for your time today.
Give them a big, big send-off, folks. A very worthwhile group they are as well. All the work they do, and we really all appreciate it. And we always have to remember, we might need to use their services at some time. Ladies and gentlemen, the Southern Golden Retriever display team! Let's bring the house down, folks. Another stunning routine. They never surprise us every year. Absolutely wonderful.
Well, that really has been a sensational display. They do it every year. The amount of work that goes into it, hardly a pour out of place during the whole routine. It was a long routine. They're getting a tremendous ovation from this wonderful crowd here. The arena absolutely packed at 12:05 on Saturday. Here in the UK, it's been full all week, let's face it. We've had some marvellous audiences, but the programme has been wonderful to watch, and we have a terrific programme of events for you in this arena during the course of the day. Everything from an international junior handling competition, the heel work to music, freestyle international competition, well worth seeing. There's a display by the RAF, we have agility. Two lots of agility during the course of the day. We have the West Midlands Police, we've got flyball, the semi-finals, and we end off the day with the Scruffs final, and we have a demonstration also by the obedience champion dog and reserve dog. They were competing today, we don't know who they are yet, but they'll be coming in the ring to give a little display of about 15 minutes at about 18:20 this afternoon UK time. And of course today is Terrier and Hound Day here at the NEC at the world's greatest dog show, Crofts 2019. Terriers and Hounds, and I'll be commentating on both of those groups together with Jessica Holm. Frank Kane won't be commentating on the groups tonight because he's judging the Hound group. Looking forward to seeing him out there. Won't be the first time, he's also judged best in show in the past here at Crofts. Wonderful dog man, a great colleague and a great friend.
12 competitors, and then we go into...
Well, we have a little pause in the ring now. I think they're doing a little rehearsal of something, so you may be able to carry on watching the pictures there. I'm not going to commentate over it. It's for something which is going to happen later in the day. We do have the Scruffs final. It could well be the rehearsal for that that's going on, but it's followed by the International Junior Handling Competition. And that's, well... That is exactly what it is. We have loads of youngsters from across the globe coming here to Crofts to take part in the handling competition. It's not the dogs that are being tested here or inspected. It will be the handlers. So the rehearsal is for Friends for Life, I believe. I've just been told, which is always good to get this information from time to time. We're actually going to see our Friends for Life now on the screen. We're going to look at the five contenders. This is a marvellous competition which the Kennel Club inaugurated several years ago. Wonderful competition. Always gets a lot of support from all over the country, all over the world, in fact. So here we go. Friends for Life 2019.